Hello and welcome to the Territorial Headquarters here again in London. So pleased to be able to share some thoughts with you, and I hope that that will be of some help to you in these continuing troubled days. Let's be honest, some of us are dealing with big stuff, illness, bereavement, sadness that evades our lives. And for those of us who have perhaps just simply been inconvenienced by the lockdown, the novelty's worn off. And many of us are feeling that kind of sense of sadness of not being able to do the things that we would love to do. We're not able to see the people we would love to see, and we're not able to do the things which we naturally enjoy. So it's going to be quite natural that for some of us there's a deflation, there's a sense of heaviness. I hope, however, that you've learnt that it's possible when you're feeling like that just to take some time out, to breathe in and to meditate and to receive from God his peace and a sense of his love to our hearts and lives. London has become very quiet. Where Jill and I live, there are planes going into Heathrow literally every 60 seconds from early in the morning till late at night, but no more. It's very quiet. And I saw on the TV just a couple of days ago the reason for that. Of course, so many planes are just parked up head to toe in all of our airports, going absolutely nowhere. When I saw those pictures, I was reminded one of the times that I flew. It was taking a group of young people from our corps in Hemel Hempstead to a corps in Moscow, Babushkino Corps, which we had joined in a twinning, and we were going on a mission. And so the seven of us were to go, and we were to take a whole group of kids on a holiday. We were also taking some emergency equipment, so I went to Aeroflot offices in London and explained to them that I'd be taking all this extra equipment. Would that be okay, knowing that we would only have 20 kilos each, 140 for the lot of us? And they assured me it would be absolutely fine. However, when we got to the check-in at Heathrow, the check-in staff of Aeroflot were having none of it, and they were not going to allow us to take the extra luggage. We had a bit of a conversation, let's put it like that, and we came to a compromise. And the compromise was that we would be able to accumulate the luggage weight. Seven of us, 20 kilos each, we were allowed 140 kilos. So we put each bag on one by one until eventually we got to the very last bag and we put it on the scales. And I can see it now, the digital weight going up and down as the final number rested. And it stopped at 139.7. One of the girls, Lucy Mann, some of you might know her, said straight away, "It's a sign. God's got something to say to us. It must be Psalm 139, verse 7. And she pulled out of her pocket her Bible and she opened up the Psalm 139, verse 7. It's marked in my Bible, Moscow weigh-in, 12th of July, 2001. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there." Remember, we're just going on an Aeroflot flight. "If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there, your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast." You can imagine, we were all laughing, but we were also all very relieved. It stayed with me ever since. Wherever I go, I know that God can be with me and indeed is with me. I hope you know that too in your circumstance today. Psalm 139, as we're there, has a whole bunch of other things to say to us. I haven't got the time to read it all to you, but I would encourage you to have a look. Psalm 139. It culminates with those wonderful words which say, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." Those of you who were with us last week will know that I said that by the end of last week's broadcast, some of you might want to take offence or will take offence. I was talking about the fences of South London and the fact that they were made out of the stretchers which used to carry injured people from the Blitz to hospital. I didn't give you offence last week, but I'm bringing you the word offensive right now. Search me. Know my heart. Test me. Know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. You know the psalmist, David, he needed his heart sorting out. Often when we read Psalm 139, we miss out the verses immediately before that. It talks about David saying how he abhors so many things, how he wishes that God would slay the wicked, how I hate those who hate you, O Lord. I abhor those who rise up against you. I have nothing but hatred for them. I count them my enemies. And then he says, search me, O God. He needed his heart sorting out. Well, I've got to be honest with you and say to you too, that God is still sorting my heart out. I still ask him to come and see whether there is any offensive way in me. We're all prone to miss the mark. We're all prone to transgress. We're all prone not to be at one with him. So search me, test me. Know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any offensive way in me. I'm sure we've all got regrets. I've got regrets. One of my biggest was when I was a divisional youth secretary running a summer school in Birmingham. And I went down to the field where the sports activities were taking place. And there was archery set up. And the kids asked me as the DYS, Captain, why don't you have a go? Let's see what you can do. So I picked up the bow. I selected an arrow. I took my aim. And I let fly. And believe it or not, that arrow flew through the air. I can see it now. And it landed plumb right in the center of the target, a bullseye. My biggest regret to this day, my biggest mistake, was picking up a second arrow and proving to everybody that the first one was such a fluke. To this day, I wish I'd just walked away. The scripture says that we all fall short of the mark. In fact, in the New Testament, the word that's translated from Greek into English mostly is a word hamartia, which is sin. It means to miss the mark. I miss the mark all the time. I guess probably you do too. But thank God we have a Christ, a Saviour, who saves us from our sin and the consequences of our sin. It's VE Day coming. We're celebrating it right now. We give thanks for victory in Europe. We remember those who gave their lives and who suffered in order that tyranny would not win. But I want to put it to you that there's another VE Day. Victory for everyone can be when we come to Jesus and we allow him to deal with the offensive ways within us, where he makes us one with himself. In the second letter of John, way back towards the end of the New Testament, and this time in the message paraphrase of that, the writer has some words for us all, whether we're veterans or whether we're newbies into the faith. He says this. This is 1 John chapter 2 and verse 12 to 13. I remind you, my dear children, your sins are forgiven in Jesus' name. You veterans were in on the ground floor and know the one who started all this. You newcomers have won a big victory over the evil one. And a second reminder, dear children, you know the Father from personal experience. You veterans know the one who started it all. And you newcomers, such vitality and strength. God's word is so steady in you. Your fellowship with God enables you to gain a victory over the evil one. Don't love the world's ways. Don't love the world's goods. Love for the world squeezes out love for the Father. Practically everything that goes on in the world Wanting your own way, wanting everything for yourself, wanting to appear important has nothing to do with the Father. It just isolates you from Him. The world and all its wanting, wanting, wanting is on the way out, but whoever does what God wants is set for eternity. The psalmist says, if there's anything offensive within us, search it out, Lord. We bring it to the light. We make our confession before Him, and we celebrate the victory of Jesus, which enables us to be one with Him. Even in our isolation, we are not to be isolated from Him. In 1 John chapter 1, John says, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. That is an amazing place to be. That is a Christian place to be. That is the way in which you and I, as His followers, are called to be, living lives of holiness, living lives of salvation, and living lives of love and hope and faith. And that brings me great comfort. I hope it brings you great joy and comfort too. So whatever your circumstance today, or you're feeling maybe a little bit down, or whether you've just had enough of this, may the peace of Christ be with you and in you as you bring to Him the very being that you are, so that His Holy Spirit might live in you and shine through you for His glory. Hallelujah. God bless you.